Now, this story, it's a great one. It's about a unique friendship that looks like it's straight out of the movies.
A firefighter, a magpie, and a cat became best friends, and they went viral online with 40 million views. To tell us the story, Matt the firefighter joins us now from New Zealand. Matt, it's lovely to see you.
Hi, guys. How's it going?
We're great, but this story's got to be the story of the day. A firefighter, a magpie, and a cat walk into a bar. It almost sounds like a joke. How did you guys all become mates?
Yeah, so it's a pretty amazing experience that I've had. I was driving down the road one day and I found a baby injured magpie on the side of the road. So I rescued her and took her home and started to embarked on my journey to become a magpie parent. But I had a cat as well, Mowgli. So I was a little bit worried about how they were going to get along. But they became best friends straight away and pretty much became inseparable. And that kind of brought joy to people all around the world with just so many views on videos that I was putting out. And so I decided to write a children's book about it. Aww. And I've just released The Story of Swoop, which is currently the third best-selling children's book in New Zealand at the moment. So I'm really stoked about that.
Huge congrats. Now, Matt, Swoop actually followed you home on runs. Can you tell us what other fun things he gets up to with yourself?
Yeah, well, Swoop, I mean, magpies are like dogs, really. They're really intelligent, so I could throw sticks and should should go and get it and bring it back to me. Basically, just very imprinted on me. I could do runs around the block and should fly beside me the whole way. She's actually gone into the wild now, and that's what the book's about. But I do have another little magpie that I'm raising at the moment called Zoe. She's down here somewhere.
Aww. She's
shy. I don't
know
where she is. She's just... Yeah, she's got a mind of her own. But yeah, she might make an appearance soon.
I love that you named the first magpie Swoop as well, which is so sweet. Did you, were you ever swooped by her?
No, never. No. Oh. I was highly respected as a parent figure. But yeah, they do. They're very misunderstood birds. And I know that in Australia that they're quite feared, but they're just protecting their babies and, you know, they're just territorial and they're just good parents. But yeah, they do remember certain faces and if you're kind to them, they'll remember you and they'll probably leave you alone.
Hey, Matt, you're kind of like a bit of an animal whisperer because randomly, a little while ago, you had ducks that arrived on your doorstep. Can you tell us why are these feathered friends so attracted to you?
You know, I have no idea. I've got a little theory that possibly when Swoop left for the wild, she went and told all the birds around the place that there was this sucker that you could talk into getting free food off. And, you know, but yeah, the ducks were amazing. I had this male Muscovy duck turn up one day and then out of the blue just turned up on my lawn. And then 3 or 4 days later, his missus comes along and joins the household. And then she ended up making herself at home and having ducklings. So I was bombarded with about 15 ducklings that I had to co-parent. And, you know, there was a big mess around the place. It was just a beautiful experience as well.
Oh, look at that backyard, though. I mean, we want to move in. Never mind the birds.
I'm very lucky to live in this beautiful place here in Awhitu, in the North Island in New Zealand.
I know you've got Zoe now and you're looking after her, but was it... When Swoop finally was released back into the wild, was that hard saying goodbye to your friend?
Look, it was really, really hard because Swoop actually came to me the week that my dad told me that he was terminal with cancer. And she stuck with me the whole period of time while he was sick and while I was looking after him. And so she helped me along with that journey. And then I went off to Dad's funeral and when I came home, Swoop had gone. That was a real tough pill to swallow, but at the same time it was bittersweet. I almost feel like she came to me at the time that I needed her the most, and she helped me through my dad's terminal cancer journey. So you know, the universe works in its own way and can't complain too much. I'm just grateful for the experience that I had with her.
Oh, that's so big. Do you think it might be a message maybe?
Oh, definitely. You know, I think the universe does work in mysterious, beautiful ways. So I'll take that one as a message.
Aww, well, you've put this beautiful book into the world, which people can buy now. It's selling well in New Zealand, isn't it?
Yeah, it's currently the third best-selling children's book in the country for 2 weeks in a row now, so I'm incredibly grateful for that outcome. But it's also available in all Australian bookshops as well.
Oh, how beautiful. Matt, we really appreciate you taking the time to speak with us today. The story of Swoop is available now. You can head to your nearest bookstore or you can order online. Thanks again, and love to Zoe as well.
lots of love back from both of us. Thank you so much.